Hi, in this new tutorial you will learn about a new compound object called the ShapeMerge. This tool will allow you to imprint a 2D shape onto a surface. You can also use it to cut out the surface using the 2D shape. So here I have this surface and I have this 2D shape. Click the surface, go to compound objects, ShapeMerge. And here you need to pick the shape. Now keep the option instance so we can preserve the original shape here. Later on we can adjust this shape and have the effect of it be updated live. So pick shape and I will pick the shape. As you can see here, the shape is imprinted on the plane. I will undo this for now. For this operation to work, if I look in the top viewport, the shape should not, the boundary of the shape, the limits of the shape should not exceed the boundary of the surface in all directions. At least one of its boundaries, one of its edges should be inside the surface. For example, here if I make this too long, now this shape is exceeding the boundary of the surface. If I go to shape merge and try to pick the shape, nothing will happen. Again, I will undo. Shape merge. Pick shape. Right click to go to turn off the button here. I can go to the rectangle, add an edit spline modifier. I can go to segments and you can see that when I change, when I move the segment, the I can see the effect, the result of the shape merge updating live. If one of the edges exceed the boundary of the surface, it's still working. Now I will go back here. Here the operation is merged. Now I can click cookie cutter and I'm creating now a cutout from the surface. I will choose merge again. For example, here I can add an edit poly to this shape merge here. If I go to polygon, this is selected by automatically. What I can do with this, I can detach it or I can give it a different material ID than the other polygons, so I can use a multi-sub object material. For example, if I'm creating a landscape, a land, and here, for example, I'm creating a street, a road in this landscape, I can have two different materials. Like I said, you can just detach it as a separate object. I can call it road, for example. And here I have this separate object. Also, here When I use the cookie cutter to create a cutout, I can use this option called invert. So, and what this does, it will keep this part and remove everything else. Now we'll see this option in a better example. Here I have the sphere and the front viewport. I will create a text. I will choose the sphere and use ShapeMerge and pick the text. Now I can imprint this text on the sphere. Like before, you can add an edit poly here and give it a different material ID or just detach it. Here in the cookie cutter, if I choose cookie cutter, now I'm creating a cutout. Can add shell, for example, and give it a thickness. I will remove this now. If you click invert, now this is what you get. It's interesting. And that's it for this tutorial. You can now go and experiment with different shapes and different geometries. And please press the like button if you like this video and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next tutorial. Thank you.